Hey, quick video to add on the macro videos. This is the last cool trick I know about macros is that if you remember the video about variable argument list where you can have a function that I don't know takes whatever int a, then you can have three dots to specify that it can take any numbers of arguments. Actually, you can do this with macros as well. So as you can see, I have a macro called printf loop here that has just an argument iterations and then three dots. And that means that you can call the printf loop with, I mean, the iteration is just a regular argument and then any number of arguments you want. And here it's just a for loop that will pass those arguments to the printf function. As you can see, you can guess get all of those arguments with the special underscore underscore VA underscore args underscore underscore macro, which will be defined when you use the three dots. So let me show you how it looks. So let's say three iterations, and here I just want to say hello, and then let's say I want a number, and then I want a string, a new line, and I'm going to print the number 32, and I'm going to print the string bar up. And as you can see, when I execute this, it will do the for loop with the variables argument that I gave to printf. So I think what it does under the hood is just literally like copy paste the string of those all of those arguments and then do printf and copy paste it in, you know. So yeah, that's what it does. And the only case I've ever used this is when I did a unit test for the printf function. So it's stuff we had to do in school where we had to rewrite the printf function, and I did a test for it because it had to be an exact replica of the real printf. And as you can see, I have like in my tester, I have a test. I mean, I have a bunch of junk. Hein? Don't judge my old code too hard. But I have a test printf macro, which takes variable arguments, and then I call the original printf with those. And I called the our like the student printf and then compare the result. And I have a bunch of like an assert printf that wraps this as well. And then you can see that here in this buffer on the right, that here I use assert printf just instead of printf. I replace printf with this, and as you can see, it can take just the regular arguments that you would pass to printf. So yeah, it's a nice trick to wrap a function. And or just whatever you want to do with variable arguments, I guess. Anyway, yeah, that's it for this video. Hopefully you're a macro master by now. And yeah, see you.